ladies and gentlemen. He's a child of God, a husband, NRA conservative, radical right-wing supervillain, and Twitter rock star. American by birth, Texan by choice, and a badass by nature. He's the owner of TomOHalloran.com, OHalloranMedia.com, and PatriotRadio.net. Please welcome Tom O'Halloran.
There ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the U.S.
And good morning. It is Friday. Welcome to Jihad on America. I'm your host, Tom O'Halloran. And I'm broadcasting today from an underground bunker deep in Arkansas, Nebraska. I'm here to educate, irritate, and agitate. And folks, if you're not fully agitated by the time this show's over, I think the terrorists, and by terrorists, I mean Democrats, have already won. Again, my name's Tom O'Halloran, otherwise known as the Mouth from the South. My primary blog, TomOHalloran.com. When you get there, please follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Spreaker, any other social media that you fancy. You can find us on Facebook at facebook.com/Patriot Radio Show. And personally, I'm at facebook.com/O'Halloran. I'm on air 5 days a week, so please tune in every morning, Monday through Thursday, 9 a.m. Texas time, for this. No, for that. For the Patriot Radio Show. On Fridays, same time, I do this. Jihad on America. Here I cover the Islamists in America. I share with you who they are, what they want, and why you should be afraid. If you've not heard my show on the Muslim Brotherhood, my show Islam is Not a Religion, or my show on Islamophobia, then please find your way to PatriotRadioShow.com. Catch all three of these shows. They'll give you insight and perspective on the Islamic issue that you've probably not heard elsewhere. They'll also give you a solid foundation upon which we build each and every Friday as we continue to pull back the mask of Islam, looking at what's being done in the name of Allah, both here and abroad. And I do the news about Islam around the world because it's a glimpse into the future of what's in store for us here in the homeland if we continue to allow the cancer of Islam to spread. Keep abreast of my shows, listen to the live stream, as well as catch up on the archives of any shows that you may have missed, all at PatriotRadioShow.com. This show is rebroadcast daily on the ConservativeRadioNetwork.com, also on Liberty Works Radio Network. You can find them at LWRN.net. You can also take the show with you on the go on your iPhone or Android by downloading the TuneIn app and just doing a search for the Patriot Radio Show. If you're a ham radio operator, I am Whiskey 2 TPO and can generally be found on Echolink Node 7212 out of Stagecoach, Texas. Before we go into the Jihad on America section of the show, there's so much going on politically. I want to touch on a couple of stories briefly. Yesterday, John Boehner said in response to "What do you think about Ted Cruz?" He says, "The devil," or "Lucifer in the flesh." Now, the internet almost broke yesterday as Satanists around the country called to complain. Their God, Satan, has been insulted. I just think that's funny. It just doesn't get much funnier than that. Yeah, Boehner said, "He's Satan in the flesh. I have friends that are Democrats, friends that are Republicans, but Cruz is the most miserable son of a bitch I've ever worked with." Wow. Yeah, and you got all the Satanists after you now, too. And on the other side of the coin, Ted Cruz pulled off something this week that I just find brilliant. I didn't think he had it in him. On Monday, or Sunday, I guess, last Sunday, he made a pact with John Kasich. Kasich is going to stay out of Indiana. He's not going to put money in it. He's not going to campaign in it. In return, Cruz will stay out of Oregon and New Mexico and let Kasich run crazy there. It turns out Kasich has failed to get on the ballot in Oregon or New Mexico. So Ted Cruz is still going to win out of those two. He won't beat Donald Trump. But Kasich doesn't stand a chance at winning of either of those two states because his people dropped the ball and he's not on the ballot in New Mexico or Oregon. Absolute brilliant. Last thing I want to touch on before we get into the jihad section is Target. I've been screaming for a boycott. American Family, something AFA has put out a formal boycott. Over 1 million people have signed this. The value of Target stock has dropped by $1 billion because Target is standing up to their... any man can go in any bathroom they want, Bill. They want to put our families at risk, our women at risk, our children at risk. We boycott Target. Target stockholders lose money, and they'll turn the board of directors over to somebody that wants to watch out for their money and our women. Shout out to my friends in the chat room, my good friend Bill Perryman. Haven't seen him online in many, many months. Good to see you back, brother. Charlie Cook, Mike Nelson, Patriot Brother Richard Silence. Good to see y'all on a Friday. Rolling into the Jihad on America section of the show, which is usually everything, but starting the show, we're going to talk about what's happened in the religion of peace over the last 30 days. In the last 30 days, there have been 125 Islamic terror attacks, killing 770 people, injuring another 1,279. That's 125 attacks in 21 countries. In the last 7 days, there have been 42 Islamic terror attacks in 11 countries, killing another 431 and injuring another 580. Since 9/11, there have been 28,241 Islamic terror attacks. Say it with me, Islamic terror attacks. Why is it that Obama can't say Islamic terror attacks? I just had a computer crash. The whole computer just went down hard. So I'm going to finish doing the show on my Android. I have a great little Samsung Galaxy Note 4, which I love. I'm a little bit handicapped on this because I don't have my mixer. I don't have my ad blocks. We're just going to shoot blind. We'll do the show straight, and I'll patch this up. It's been a tough week. With the storms we've had down here, I had my internet connection go out a couple of times on me on Monday and again on Tuesday. But we've survived it all. So over the past week, the Islamic terror attacks that we have had include, in Nigeria, 48 people are reported dead after Muslim terrorists attacked their village, hacking, shooting, and burning their homes and church. 48 dead, 60 severely wounded. Syria, a car bomb strikes a Shiite mosque, killing 6 bystanders, wounding another 42. Afghanistan, over 60 are killed when religious extremists... Oh, really? Religious extremists? That's novel. When religious extremists stage a massive attack on a government building that begins with suicide bombing, 64 dead, 347 severely wounded. And numerous other smaller ones with 2, 4, and 6 people dead. Again, this is what they call the religion of peace. They exist to kill non-believers, but these were all Muslim-on-Muslim killings. If they will kill them, their own kind, without hesitation, in fact, with relish, then why would anybody think for a minute that they would hesitate to kill you or me? Truth is, the Muslims don't hesitate to kill anybody. In fact, since 1948, I was born only 5 years later. Since 1948, there have been 11 million Muslim-on-Muslim killings. This isn't all told. This is Muslim-on-Muslim killings. A stark number. Some 11 million Muslims have been violent and killed, of which 35,000, or 3%, died during the 60 years of fighting Israel, or just one out of every 315 Muslim fatalities. In contrast, over 90% of the 11 million who perished were killed by fellow Muslims. Conflict since 1950 with over 10,000 fatalities. 40 million Red China, outright killing of men. Okay, these aren't Muslims. Pardon me, I've got a list that is of something else completely. So we're going to skip that list. That's just the number of people that have died, period. In California, a Muslim son is suspect behind the couple's murder with a message, "Sorry, my first kill was clumsy." Couple was found slain in their home in San Jose on Sunday next to a message written on the floor saying that, "Sorry, my first kill was clumsy." Police officer found the bodies of Golam Rabi and his wife Shamia, according to the San Jose Police Department. This time, he is not considered a suspect, but the son is being sought regarding the incident. Morales didn't confirm or deny the eerie message. Both Evergreen and South Bay Islamic Association, where the rabbis were longtime members, shared a prayer for the family. So this is some Islamic son killing his parents. The reason we don't know at this time. Obama. The Obama administration awards $270,000 to the terror-linked Islamic charity. According to the Washington Free Beacon, the Department of Health and Human Services has granted a $270,000 grant to the Islamic Relief Worldwide, the largest Islamic charity in the world. The grant was awarded as part of a larger project to provide both health services in Nairobi through the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. The problem is that the Birmingham, England, Islamic Relief Worldwide and the Islamic Relief USA, the largest Muslim charities in the United States and affiliate IRW, are banned in many countries over its links to Hamas. It's just another of network of Islamic terror charities. They set up all of these nice charities to make themselves sound respectable, like organizations that you'd want to have in your community. But we know otherwise. The charity's accounts show that it has partnered with a number of organizations linked to terrorism, and that some of the charity's trustees are personally affiliated with extreme Islamic groups that have connections to terror. And yet the Obama administration has no problem funding them. In August of 2014, an IRUSA official was elected to the Islamic Society of North America to be its new president. I'm looking for the guy's name. Aziz's election to such high-profile position is somewhat surprising given the steady decline in Islamic Relief USA's credibility and reputation over the last several years. USA's budget tumbled after the charity was revealed to have falsely inflated the value of its drug stockpiles, which represented a significant share of their total assets. So they're inflating the value of their stockpile so that they can get money, and they use the money for typical terrorist stuff like bombs, weapons,
machetes to cut off little Christian babies' heads. The Department of Education, United States. This is Barack Hussein Obama's Department of Education, is encouraging Islam in the classrooms. They think by teaching Islam, it's a way to stop Muslims from bullying. Yes, if you cave in to Islam, they'll respect you, sure. The DOE in the United States has encouraged educators to be more responsible in protecting Muslim students from bullying by teachers in Islam class, by teaching Islam in class. Many people rejected the demands of the DOE's instructions by saying that it is inappropriate to bring up religion in class. The DOE posted instructions on their website urging teachers to include Islam in the classroom discussions. I'm all for that. Mention Islam in the classroom discussions. Now, when you're talking about the mass genocide of Christians worldwide, the alleged bullying is said to largely be based on the lack of information about the religion and its tendencies to and the tendency to associate Islam with terrorism. Gee, I wonder why that is. The federal government is so clueless on this. Although no firm statistics show how often Muslim students are bullied, activists claim that the number became higher after the attacks of 9/11, according to the Huffington Post. A 2010 survey of 57 Muslim teenagers aged 11 to 18 reported being called a name because of their faith. About 80% of the respondents also said they had been called a terrorist. The DOE cites an increase of incidents targeting Muslim community due to the 10 incidents that happened worldwide, according to WorldNet Daily. Of the 10 incidents, 2 resulted in assaults, 3 reported vandalism of mosques, 5 involved alleged threats and intimidation, and only 1 involved a student inside school. Parents were also called to educate their kids on how to prevent bullying. Parents were told to teach how to appreciate their peers and make friends across different cultures. However, many groups rejected the claim of the DOE by organizing a change.org petition drive demanding the department stop the efforts to Islamicize children in school. That's phenomenal. I had missed that. Many groups rejected the claim of the DOE by organizing a change.org petition. The people are pushing back against the government, demanding that they stand down and stop trying to force Islam on our children. That is the best news I have read all month. And segueing from that one, another Muslim minor inconvenience hate hoax gets shot down. Actual minorities have hate crimes. Muslims mainly seem to have minor inconveniences, like the Muslim passenger who was supposedly refused a can of Diet Coke by the flight attendant only because she was Muslim, or the Muslim who allegedly suffered dirty looks, or were asked to leave a coffee shop after 45 minutes of hogging a table. A very popular eatery in Orange County came under fire over a video that went viral. In the video, a woman claims that she and her friends were asked to leave the Earth, URTH Cafe in Laguna Beach, California, for being Muslim. Sarah Farshak said the woman posted the video on Facebook claimed she and her Muslim friends were the victims of discrimination at the Earth Cafe. She explained that they were asked to leave after 45 minutes to free up a table for customers ordering at the counter. For some reason, this incredibly Islamophobic coffee shop let her and her friends order, sit and hang out for 45 minutes, and then only asked them to leave after 45 minutes, which is their policy. But the owner of the restaurant said the woman's claims are not true. ABC reached out to the cafe, which said it does have a policy that patrons must give up or share their table after 45 minutes when it's busy. The owner said there were people waiting in line that evening. Everybody wants an outside seat. We have this policy of making things fair and accommodating everyone that wants to enjoy our cafe. To make things clear, Berkman stated the women were not asked to leave because they were Muslim. The owner said, "My wife is Muslim. I am Jewish. We like to say we're a sign of world peace." Once again, another racist hate crime against Muslims has been debunked, like most others before it. Breaking news down in Texas. The cartels are helping terrorists in Mexico get to the United States to explore targets. Mexican drug traffickers help Islamic terrorists stationed in Mexico cross to the United States to explore targets for future attacks. According to information forwarded to Judicial Watch by high-ranking Homeland Security officials, among the jihadists that travel back and forth through the porous southern border is a Kuwaiti named Sheikh Mahmoud Omar, an ISIS operative who lives in the Mexican state of Chihuahua, not far from El Paso, Texas. Kabir trained hundreds of Al-Qaeda fighters in Pakistan, Afghanistan, and Yemen. He's lived in Mexico for more than a year. Now Kabir trains thousands of men, mostly Syrians and Yemenis, to fight in an ISIS base situated in the Mexico-U.S. border region near Ciudad Juarez. The intelligence gathered by Judicial Watch's source reveals they're staking out U.S. targets. It is not difficult, and Kabir actually brags in an Italian newspaper article published last week that the border region is so open he could get in with a handful of men and kill thousands of people in Texas or Arizona in the space of just a few hours. The Foreign Affairs Secretary Claudia Ruiz, Mexico's top diplomat, said in the article that she doesn't understand why the Obama administration and the U.S. media are culpably neglecting this phenomenon, adding that this new wave of fundamentalism could have nasty surprises in store for the United States. But you see, Obama doesn't care about nasty surprises. Obama doesn't care about the risks and the hazards to the American people. All Obama cares about is how he can hurt the United States of America. Nothing else truly matters to Obama. Was an 18-year-old boy the latest victim of Muslim hostility to Christians? A Christian boy in Pakistan has allegedly been hanged by Muslims who believed he was attached to a Muslim girl who lived across from his brother's house. A report in the Pakistan Christian Post cites an investigation from the Voice Society, which concluded that an 18-year-old Kasir Masih was killed by the girl's family in an attack led by her father, Mohammed Bia. Previous reports had said that he had been murdered for resisting drug traffickers, while according to The Voice, local police have been treating it as a suicide. Kasir's family attended the Roman Catholic Church in Pir Malal, around 300 kilometers from Lahore. According to The Voice, the family Meshwi, the Muslim girl who he wished to marry, had warned him not to have anything to do with their daughter. But as lovers had done since the days of Romeo and Juliet, albeit a fictional story, they don't listen to the warnings, and this young Christian boy was murdered. In the Philippines, Manny Pacquiao was the target of a Philippine Islamist group, Abu Sayyaf. The Islamist group accused of beheading a Canadian hostage in the Philippines may have plotted to kidnap boxing star Manny Pacquiao. President Aquino said that Abu Sayyaf militants who made threats against him and his family and wanted to explode bombs in Manila to try to get funding from ISIS. They're allegedly even hatching plots to kidnap Pacquiao or one of his children, as well as my sister Chris or one of their children, with a plan to use them in bargaining for the release of their cohorts, Aquino said, referring to his younger sister. Threats against my own life have been investigated. This from President Benigno Aquino. Aquino said the plans were uncovered and the country's troops had reduced military's ability to inflict harm. Thousands of New Yorkers have been recently named as apparent targets of the Islamic State. An online group claiming Islamic State ties has threatened 3,600 New Yorkers and distributed their personal information last week on a secure messaging app. Islamic State supporters published the names and addresses of 3,600 New Yorkers in an apparent hit list, seemingly meant to escalate the group's campaign of sowing fears far from the battlefield in Syria. While the hacker group is claiming allegiance to the IS, they've previously published these kinds of threatening target lists. Those data dumps have typically included information about U.S. military, government officials, and diplomatic officers rather than just citizens. Independent security analysts who discovered the list and showed it to Passcode said it is unclear how IS supporters obtained the names and addresses of that list. Their names were released last week by a group calling itself United Cyber Caliphate on the encrypted chat application Telegram, which IS supporters are known to use to recruit supporters and spread propaganda. I've been telling you for 350-something shows that we take a look at what's happening in the EU. We look at what's happening in Europe, in the UK. And we know what is going to happen here, because they learn things over there and they bring them here. We have time to pay attention, to listen, to do something about it, to prevent it, to identify who the bad eggs are here, where the mosques are that are preaching the hatred, the mosques that are breeding the ferment, and we have the ability to shut them down. Why don't we? Egypt is closing 2,500 mosques to put an end, or at least to stem the flow of terrorism. In Africa, they're closing mosques. They're just bombing them. They're leveling the mosques, because that is where the Muslims go to have their meetings, to work out their plans, to spread their hate, their evil plans for terror. There is something that can be done. The problem is, who will do it? I'm going to take a break. If you're listening to this show live, please refresh your browsers in about 30 seconds. I've got my computer back up. We'll finish the show with the mixer, and I'll patch it all together after the show, like I have earlier in the week when the internet went down. Oh, cannot connect to the server. Okay, we seem to still have an issue here somewhere. I'll give this one last shot. Oh, I can't do it because I'm on the line here. Okay, my friends, I'm going to take a quick break. There'll be dead air for just a few seconds. Then the ad block will start up, and I'll be back with my mixer shortly after. Please stick around. And we are back. Seems I had an open mic. I thought I was running an ad break there for a couple of minutes. And I had forgot to push one button on it, so we had an open mic during the commercial break. Hope you enjoyed the commercials. Yeah, it's been a mess this week. My shows are typically ended up in three pieces and required considerable editing afterwards, but the end product is usually sufficient. The race for presidents, for the president of the United States,
So far, there's only one man that has a idea of what needs to be done to protect America. Only one. Donald Trump. Even the conservative Ted Cruz doesn't think it's who we are to ban Islam. It's not what we are as who we are as Americans. Bullshit. Islam is about submission. It is about killing those that disagree with you. And if you cannot look over at Europe and see what's happening, see what these savages will do. If you can't look at that and say, we don't want that here, then how in the hell do you think you have a chance to be elected? Donald Trump gets it. We need to stop letting them in. Step two is evaluate who's here. Identifying those with Islamic terrorist leanings. And deport them. Not watch them, not build a database on them. Deport them. There's one other man that has a chance for becoming president. And I'm not a fan of bringing a third party in. And I would have been all against it till they told me what name is being bandied about. But they say there are billionaires lining up behind him. I believe that means Koch brothers, Sheldon Adelson out of Las Vegas. And if he goes for it, Donald Trump may lose a lot of support. Because General Mad Dog Mattis is one badass SOB. General Mattis is a 32-year Army veteran, if I'm not mistaken. He said, I want nothing to do with politics, which coincidentally is exactly what Ike Eisenhower said, our last general. Mad Dog Mattis has repeatedly talked about Islam and the fact that they're savages. I love General Mad Dog Mattis. In fact, I've got one of his quotes on the back of my business card. That's how much I love this guy. The quote I have says, be polite. Be professional. But have a plan to kill everybody that you meet. I just love that. He's also told a story of during World War II in the Philippines, when we were fighting Muslims over there. They dug a hole. They pushed the terrorists into this great big hole, and they filled the hole up. And then they let a handful of Muslims go. They went back and told everybody what we did. And the Muslims hadn't attacked America again for many, many years. Yeah, Mad Dog Mattis. Bromance indeed. You'll have every veteran in the United States, every combat soldier currently serving, voting for this man. He's 62 years old. He's never been in politics, but he's always served his country. And anything they can do to add someone no one's voted for in the race. I agree with you, Richard. It's a mess now. It's a mess. This would be a third-party candidate. He'd probably take from Trump and take from Bernie and Hillary and all that. It would be a mess. But if it worked, oh my word, what a difference. What a difference. A level-headed, educated military leader. Could be the best thing that ever happened. But until then, we have Donald Trump. And he's got my respect. And I have marks on my head from banging it on the desk over things that he's done and said. But Donald Trump is still the only one in the game that has a chance to straighten and save America. Okay, switching gears. Muslim sex attacks in Austria. Vienna's deputy mayor says we need an immediate stop to refugees into the country. An immediate stop. People often forget that Islam is the most sex-addicted religion in the world. Everything is built on sex. How the Muslim lives, how he eats, how he marries, the laws he must follow, how he worships Allah, how he fights for Allah. It's all a maze of rules and advice built on the instructions on legalized management of sex addiction without facing instant purgatory. And of course, if his sexual obsession can exist within legal norms during the Muslim lifetime on earth, then he gets even more sex in Jannah, the Islamic version of heaven, where the 72 virgins are waiting to serve millions of Muslim males. Now, these guys are just too stupid to figure this out. But if they're raping kids at the age of 3 and 5 and 8, what are they expecting in the 72 virgins thing? Young goats? I mean, really. The mayor said, in the latest shocking incident of a 27-year-old woman who was allegedly assaulted while waiting at a bus station in the village of Grinzing on the outskirts of Vienna. She said that he was Arab-looking and had a cord around his waist instead of a belt. All he could say was sex, sex, sex. Then he pulled out a condom from his trouser pocket. The results were a strong sign of the discontent surrounding the escalating migrant crisis, paving the way for disruption of the two-party government system, which has ruled the country since 1945. The woman said she tried to run away, but the attacker chased after her with his trousers down, and she only managed to escape when she reached a police station. In a second incident, a 19-year-old girl was followed into a toilet where she was assaulted by the man who she described as a foreigner. Vienna's deputy mayor said it cannot go on like this, and there needs to be an immediate stop to allowing refugees into the country and the extradition of anyone who is involved in a crime. The security of the people of Austria has to be the priority. See, another politician that gets it. You're there to serve the people, the natives, the people that live there, not the migrants, not the savages. Norway. They're bribing fake asylum seekers with thousands of dollars to leave. Norwegian immigration offices giving hundreds of asylum seekers a bonus of 10,000 kroner. That's about £800, $800, to leave the country voluntarily, on top of the thousands already offered in expenses. The Norwegian Directorate of Immigration has announced they will pay the bribe to the first 500 migrants that agree to return to their home nation without a fight. We need to entice more people to leave the country by giving them a little bit more money on their way out. This will save us a lot of money because it's expensive to have people in the asylum centers. Well, that's one way to do it. I'd much rather pay to get them gone than pay by suffering the rapes and the death within the country. In Germany, Merkel's Muslims have left blood, feces, and semen smeared on the asylum home walls. An asylum home was vacated when the when Barack Obama traveled to Germany to meet with Merkel last week. His security team needed a place to stay. So his whole security team took over the police barracks. That forced the local police to move into a recently vacated migrant center, which had been totally trashed, smeared with blood, vomit, feces. This is just the way these savages live. The officers were asked to stay in the former migrant home as their own police barracks were accommodating security team members attached to Obama. Wet patches of the floor in the bunk beds were covered with vomit that was stuck into the carpet. Police refused to sleep in the filthy conditions, opting instead to sleep in their trucks parked at a zoo. And that they did. Picture online showed about 20 police cars in the zoo with giraffes wandering around. Rather to sleep in a car than into a cesspool left by these savages. From the chat room, pay them to leave. That kind of leaves a bad taste in my mouth, but whatever works, I suppose. Yeah, pay them to leave. I'd rather just napalm the bunch of them. Take care of the problem once and for all. Shut down every unconstitutional organization that has an alphabet name with it. Keep the FBI and the SS. There you go. Another honor killing. Young man is remanded into police custody for killing his sister. This out of Pakistan. Judicial magistrate remanded on Thursday a young man who murdered his teenage sister for honor. Hyatt stabbed Sumera multiple times after beating her severely in their house. The accused has also confessed to the crime in police custody, saying he caught his sister talking to a boy on the doorstep of the home. He was inside his bedroom. As soon as he arrived at the door, the boy fled away. The young man said, "I repeatedly asked her not to go to the door, but she did not listen." The brother appeared to be in his 20s. He said, "This infuriated me, and I grabbed a kitchen knife and stabbed her 4 to 5 times." According to investigating officers, the 17-year-old girl begged her brother to take her to the hospital, but he refused. The neighbors came and caught him and informed the police, called the police on him. Killing your sister for talking to a boy. Oh, let's see. Again, Pakistan. A Christian woman gang raped in Pakistan as attacks against believers escalate. Christian women from Christian community mourn for their relatives who were killed by a suicide attack on a church during the funeral in Lahore last month. Suicide bombings outside two churches in Lahore killed 14 people and wounded nearly 80 others during services. See, they kill one person and they wait for everybody to come around for the funeral. And then they kill many. From the chat room, Richard says, FBI and SS have no place in our Constitution. I'd rather see a solution that pays those who paid in and then shut the SS down. Mike Nelson says, that was my first impulse, but held back a little bit, thinking, now why? Napalm. Cluster bombs, bunker busters. Drop a bunker buster on every mosque in America. That will get the mosque itself and the catacombs beneath. The Christian women are all whores, and they would come back and repeat their debauchery if I told anyone. So I feel unclean now. I have done nothing wrong. I want these men to be punished and hope that the law will protect me. The Muslims are killing Christians around the world. This latest attack I've just told you about is in Pakistan, but it has happened everywhere. Throughout Africa, Libya, Syria, Afghanistan. They will kill you in a heartbeat. Shifting gears, ISIS recruiters arrested, including sisters who worked at a Moscow airport and for Russian intelligence, after a raid on an apartment uncovers grenades and explosives. Russia has a very low tolerance for this whole ISIS crap. Sources cited by pro-Kremlin media outlet Life News said, according to information from the Secret Service, all are active ISIS recruiters. A woman named only as Sadia K was reported to be working at Vnukov Airport in Moscow, used by major airlines, but also VIPs, including Vladimir Putin and senior officials, as well as visiting foreign dignitaries. These people are likely to go to jail in Moscow and never be seen again, because they don't mess around, unlike Obama. who would get them released from jail and hire them into the White House. Islamic terror attack planned for the Israeli embassy and Vatican attacks. One of four Islamist terrorist suspects arrested on Thursday allegedly wanted to attack the Vatican and the Israeli embassy in Rome. And the Italian police have arrested four people in a foreign fighter investigation, including a Moroccan-born man living in Italy with orders from the so-called Islamic State terror group to carry out attacks in Rome during the Holy Year. The man allegedly received a message urging him to commit terror attacks in Italy. Dear Brother Abraham, Abderhaim, I send you the bomb poem. Listen to the Sheikh and strike. The content of a WhatsApp message to the arrested suspect. That was the content of the message. If anybody tells you that Islam is a peaceful religion, just look at them and laugh. You can't argue with their level of ignorance. These savages have killed 13 million people. Oh, it's 11 million people since 1948. I think the number over the last 1,400 years was some 300 million people. Out of the chat room, Charlie Cook says, Arab company just got awarded a contract to maintain Air Force One. Yeah, I saw that. I meant to do a piece on that. I'll cover that this next week. In Saudi Arabia, a company of Muslims got a contract to do maintenance on Air Force One. Now, a lot of these people are trained. They're trained at MIT. They're highly skilled people, some of the Saudis. So I'm not saying they couldn't do the job. But in addition to doing the job, they could also plant a bomb that would go off sometime after, say, the next president is sworn in, when the plane reaches 20,000 feet. They can plant devices that will listen to anything that goes on the plane from the communication centers. Why are we giving contracts to our enemies, to people that we know that are funding terrorism? Why are we giving them contracts dealing with Air Force One? It isn't about Obama. It's about Air Force One. That is our airplane. Shouldn't it be taken care of by our people? By our people. In the chat room, Obama has kicked Christian leaders out of the military and put Muslim sympathizers in their place. Mike Nelson says, Tom, not the bombs, the bugs. Yes, that's where I was going. Yes. Everything this man does just gives us more reasons why we should have impeached his miserable, American-hating Muslim ass years ago. And I'm ashamed. I'm ashamed that the Congress, the Senate that we put in place last November, hasn't made that happen. No, we elected them November 2 years ago. They were seated last January. We've had the people in place. Why has Congress been so cowardly? Too cowardly to indict an obvious traitor, an obvious treason man, treasoner, treasonist. Washington Times article being posted there, U.S. military hostile to Christians under Obama, morale and retention. Yes, indeed. That's from Washington Times. My friends, have a blessed weekend. My apologies for the show being so choppy today. Sometimes the technology is just something we have to live with. If you want to listen to the show to catch the whole thing streamlined, it will be available within the hour right here on patriotradioshow.net.com. And that, my friends, is the rest of the show. God bless you and yours, America. This is Tom O'Halloran. I'm out. Have a blessed weekend. Shout out to the chat room. I appreciate you guys more than you can know. Mike Nelson, Ken Crow, Bill Perriman, Charlie Cook, Richard Silence, my patriot brothers. Love you all. The ladies are missing today. Catherine, Marilyn Katz, Sally. A couple others I'm drawing a blank, but have a blessed weekend, friends.